Hi, this is Kat Allman with Google's Open Source Programs Office. I'm here today with my colleague, Carol Smith. Carol manages our Google Summer of Code program, and we're here today for the second of our interviews about that program. Specifically, we're here today to talk about applying as a mentoring organization. So, Carol, what the heck is a mentoring organization anyway?
So mentoring organizations, at a minimum, are organizations which have already released code under an OSI-approved license and have at least two contributors in their community who would like to participate in the program as mentors and org admins.
And can a school be a mentoring organization?
They can. We've had universities participate in the past, again, assuming that they've released code under an OSI-approved license and they have at least two contributors who would like to participate. But they should keep in mind that if they have any requirements from their university in terms of their time, that they should make sure that they can balance those two things.
And can a company be a mentoring organization?
They can. We're a little more restrictive about which companies we accept. Again, they have to meet the requirements of having already released code under an OSI-approved license, which may or may not be the case for some companies. But yes, they're still welcome to apply.
Great. Why would an organization or a free and open source software project want to participate?
For a couple reasons. One is because they might get code that they might not have otherwise been able to create from the student developers who participate in the program. And also we've heard from organizations that they get recognized on a wider, broader international open source stage.
Right. How much of a time commitment is it?
For mentors, it tends to be about 5 hours a week, but it will really depend on how the organization's code base is, what sorts of projects they have the students working on, and sort of how they treat and work with new developers. So we just try to give that as a general guideline.
Okay. And what about the org admin role? What's involved in being the org admin for the project?
Quite a few things. One is submitting the application to participate in the program, but also they need to be able to sort of manage the entire scope of participating in Google Summer of Code, so making sure that the mentors are submitting their evaluations on time during the program, making sure that the students are on track, making sure the projects are all on track, and also submitting all the forms and all the things that are required by Google as well.
Okay. Related to that, Google uses the Melange software that we've developed to run the program. Is that optional, or do projects have to work with Melange?
They have to use Melange, and anything that they do outside of Melange isn't recognized by Google as part of the program, and so they're still welcome to do that, but they need to duplicate that effort within our project.
Great. All important question, when's the application period?
So applications are open right now, which is great, and the application deadline is next week on Friday, February 14th at 1900 UTC, which if you're on the west coast of the US is 11 a.m.
Great. What about the application itself? Are there any gotchas, or where can they get help?
So if they would like to just get some general guidelines on how to submit their application, I would direct them to our website, which is google-melange.com. And on that site, we have a pretty extensive FAQs, which has information about their ideas pages and also about participating as a mentoring organization generally. And then within the FAQs, we also have linked a mentor and org admin manual, which is actually written by mentors and org admins who have participated in the past and intended for exactly these kinds of people who'd like to participate in the program. If they still have questions that they haven't gotten answered or they'd like help with their application, we also have a general discussion mailing list that they can ask their specific question on.
Great. Is there a single most common mistake that orgs should look out for?
One of the most common mistakes is not spending enough time on your ideas page. As part of the application to be a mentoring organization, we ask all the applicants to submit what's called an ideas page, which is essentially just a list of the projects that they think students might like to work on during the summertime. But we want them to make sure that they've really thought about what that project is going to look like, how much of a time commitment it's going to be, whether they have the potential mentors to mentor that project, and really what the sort of difficulty level is. So if anything, I would recommend that organizations spend most of their time on making sure their ideas page is really high quality.
Great. If an org has applied and been rejected in the past, is it a waste of time for them to apply again?
Absolutely not. having been rejected in the past is no bearing on what decisions we make in any given year of applications. But if they've gotten feedback on what was wrong with their application or why they were rejected in the past, I'd recommend that they definitely integrate that and change those things for this year's application.
Great. Have I forgotten to ask you anything that you get asked a lot online?
But we always have lots of students who are interested in volunteering for open source projects. So if they are even thinking about applying for GSOC, they can definitely start talking to students and potential applicants now if they like to.
Fantastic. Well, thank you very much, Carol. And thank you all for joining us. If you have an open source project and you're considering applying, we certainly hope you do. And happy GSOC.